Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Click the bell button and enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.
This video, we're going to kind of review it and talk about what is coming to this device, or if you haven't updated what is on this device. You can see that gallery looks exactly like the Galaxy S9 Plus. As a matter of fact, pretty much all the icons have been updated to basically match that of the S9 Plus. So now the Note 8 kind of feels just like what you would get, exactly like what you would get on the Galaxy S9 Plus. So this is a nice update to the Samsung Galaxy Note 8 if you want to get your Note 8 looking more premium. We're going to talk about battery life and stuff like that, but this thing came in at 1,122 megabytes. Let's go ahead and show the version here. So Android 8.0 Oreo, you can see, is now available on the device, and that's from Google, but also Samsung Experience version 9.0, and this brings quite a few enhancements that we're going to talk about along this video. But really, Samsung did some optimizations to make the Note 8 a little bit smoother on this Android Oreo update. So one of the first things that they brought here I want to show you is the Home app shortcut. So what is this? Basically, it's like a 3D touch-like feature for the Note 8. So if you hold down YouTube, you see you can now search your subscriptions, trending, stuff like that. You can go to calculator and you can see it's gone there. There's nothing there. So some of the applications are not supported, but things like calendar are supported, for example, add event, add task, and search. So some apps are going to be supported with this and some aren't, but that's a new feature here on Android Oreo for the Note 8. You can see that the settings menu is slightly different. It has this little like icon up here that kind of matches that of the Galaxy S9 and looks exactly the same here in the settings menu. But also there's a new notifications thing that came to this device, and that is app icon badges with notification dots. This is new here for Android 8.0, and it matches that of what you would get on like a Pixel device. You can also show it with the numbers, so you have the option to change these here on the Note 8, which is a nice touch for this device. So another new feature is Samsung updated their keyboard to bring new emojis and make it simpler to get to things like stickers. And they also brought GIFs here in the keyboard. So this is pretty cool to see, kind of like what Apple has on the iPhone, but this is nice here. You also have some stickers here. You can go through them and download some more. And you have the all new updated emojis that no longer just look odd. Now these actually look usable. Very nice stuff here to see these emojis updated. It's been forever since people have been requesting this, and Samsung finally listened to their customers. So all new emojis here, and then you can go ahead and use voice activation there. You can get to settings real easily right there. So an updated keyboard, and it is a little bit accurate, and it's better than ever here on Android 8.0 for the Note 8. Next up is system performance. System performance has gotten a little bit better here on the Note 8. It has 6 gigs of RAM with a Snapdragon 835, so it is a beast when it comes to performance. And I found that it's just a little snappier than it was on Nougat. There's a little less twitch. It's still not as quick as the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus, but it's almost identical. I mean, it's like half a second difference or so. You would never notice unless you put them side by side. So very fast system performance. In addition to that, Samsung is now limiting background services to go ahead and improve the battery life on Android 8.0, as well as background inefficiency. So if things are running in the background, Samsung is basically going to tell the Note to shut those down to save you battery life and give you a better performer. Now, this might close some things, so you might have run into a time where you might have to reload something here and there, but overall you should have a better system performance on 8.0 for the Note 8. The Edge screen also sees some enhancements. It's actually totally new fonts on here, and it's just a little bit bigger, easier to read. Things just look a little bit cleaner. The weather icon, like when you go into the weather, the color behind the weather is just a little bit different, more updated, looks cleaner, looks closer to what you get on the Galaxy S9 Plus, so that's nice to see as well. If you do go into the Edge and you go to the settings here, you can go back on this little back button and you can go into Edge lighting. There's also new colors in here. So if we go to Edge effect lighting styles, go to colors, there's new colors on board here if you do use Edge lighting. So that's nice to see here on the Galaxy Note 8. Also, you can change the handle now just by holding it and moving it around like this on Android 8.0. You can move different sides if you want to change over your Edge. That's, you know, if you use the Edge a lot, this can be very useful. But one thing that doesn't really change here with the Note 8 is the S Pen. So there's no real enhancements when it comes to the S Pen. Not that anybody was requesting them. They do have plenty of software features here, but there's no new features when it comes to the S Pen. So just keep that in mind if you were wondering about that. So here's a new feature as well. On the lock screen, you now have the ability to change your clock styles, and there's more of them than before. So there's a little bit more tweaking and customization going on to the clock on the lock screen. And there's also some more tweakability when it comes to the lock screen on the always-on display. So just like the lock screen clocks I just showed you, there's more customization going on here with always-on display. So that's a nice touch as well. If you did enjoy that feature, which I think a lot of Samsung users do enjoy, you can tweak that a little bit more now. The secure folder now has the ability to sync to the Samsung cloud. In case you lose your phone, all your files will be saved. That's new here for the Samsung Galaxy Note 8. So keep that in mind. If you do use this a lot, you might want to go ahead and sync it up to your Samsung cloud. Bluetooth also sees some updates to higher quality codecs. So the Bluetooth experience for the Note 8, if you thought it was a little iffy on Android 7.0, it is improved here. Connections are more reliable and quicker to use, and it supports more codecs. So keep that in mind if you are updating. This is going to be a great update if you were having issues with Bluetooth on your Android Nougat on the Galaxy Note 8. Now, if you are shooting a video with your Samsung Galaxy Note 8 and you want to go play it in the video player, there's a new feature that now allows you to go ahead and watch this. So if we click this little 1X, it'll show you the playback speed. You see this right here, and you could tweak it all the way up to 2X. So that's new here for the Samsung Galaxy Note 8. If you were wondering, that's a new feature. The clock now sees the ability to go into landscape mode, but you cannot do this on the home screen. So you can now put the clock in landscape mode. If you were wondering, why does my clock not rotate? Well, that's here now for Android 8.0, a small thing, but you know what? You cannot rotate the home screen like you can on the S9 Plus, which I think is a bit of a bummer because the Note 8's a bigger device and a device I would argue is more productive than the Galaxy S9 Plus, yet they don't allow you to go in landscape. It's like, come on, Samsung, really, just throw it in there. It's a Note device. We want to throw it in landscape. It's the size of a tablet almost anyway. Heading off into battery, there's not much of a change here when it comes to the UI and battery. You still have all your great power saving modes that allows you to go the distance, but how has my experience been so far? I can tell you right now, I've been very happy with the battery life on Android 8.0 for this device. It's been actually better than what I've seen on 7.0. The percentages are just going down slower than ever. So I think that if you were worried about battery life, don't worry about it on the Note 8 for this 8.0. It's definitely worthy of your update when it comes to the battery life. We don't see no real changes to the camera UI. So if you were expecting that, you know, Galaxy S9 AR emoji stuff and all that new, you know, UI elements that come from the S9, it's not coming here. So get used to it. This is what you're going to be with for a while here on the Note 8, the same UI that it came with out of the box since day one. So that's pretty much it. There's a few other things that I don't want to really point out here. They're just small things behind the scenes, but that's all the forward-facing stuff you're really going to see here. It's basically a cleanup of some of the bugs, some of the mess in the prior version of Nougat, and it's a little bit more refined and definitely worth the update if you were wondering. It's a large update, but if you have fast Wi-Fi, it should go pretty quick, and it's exciting to see this, even though it's quite late. You know, the Pixel 2 has had it since day one. It's still a nice update for this device, and I definitely would recommend it. Have you updated to your Note 8? Let us know your experience down below in the comment section of this video.